T-shirt has purple in there.
Guess who's back? Back again.
John and Nat.
Tell a friend.
Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess. Now I want to hear the song.
I know. I'm just kidding. It's a catchy tune.
Catchy tune. Oh, look it. They have a deeper purple one.
Oh, that's cool.
Are they open?
I think so. Ooh. You want to go in there, check it out?
Yeah.
Let's go check it out. I didn't know that, but I guess Virginia's gift shop doesn't open until 10, like the park. So for some reason, I thought it got opened earlier before the park.
They should open earlier. That way, while you're waiting for the park to open, you can do some shopping.
We could do some spending knots if it was open.
Some damage.
Right now.
Hey guys, we're here for the Boysenberry Festival at Knott's Berry Farm 2024. Here to check out all the good stuff that they have in store for us today. Can't wait to see all the decor and try some of all the yummy food that they're offering this year.
Yeah, so come join us. We're excited. I'm wearing my purple.
I'm kind of wearing purple.
He's good. His shirt has purple in there.
Yeah.
So come along and see what we find and the goodies that we find. And yeah, come join us. Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh.
Here we are, guys. 9:40 and we are in. But we're still kind of walking around. I think they still have some things closed off.
Mm-hmm.
Hasn't officially opened up yet, but should be
They
opening.
Opened up a little early, is awesome. So awesome. First day of the Boysenberry Festival.
Yeah. That's cool. All right. Well, let's go get our Boysenberry on.
Yes. Come join us. But first, we need the Boysenberry.
Oh, yeah.
Tasty card.
Let's go find that.
Let's go find it. Come along.
What do you think of that? Approve?
Approve? Or, oh, there's more over there.
Where?
There's more over here. Yeah. I like it's soft. The material's soft.
Oh, yeah.
So is this one. This one's soft.
This one has a little more sparkle to it.
It has a sparkle. I like that.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
$24.99 for that one.
Yeah. That one's nice. I like that. Ooh, look at that sweatshirt.
Oh, yeah.
Dang.
Oh, that is cool.
I like that one.
What's that go for? $45.
$45. Oh, and it has Knott's Berry Farm on the side.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
That's pretty cool.
That is cool.
Yeah.
Nice. Oh, we saw that one last week too, didn't we?
Yeah.
The sweater too.
Oh, and this sweater.
Yeah. This is nice. This is like
nice.
A sport shirt.
Yeah.
Like a sport sweater.
Like a sport sweater.
Actually, this is different than the one we saw.
It's
this
a little
is
different.
More, it's
huh?
got like the sport vibe to it. I'm $70 for that.
$70. Yeah.
Cool.
Oh, they have
the sports line.
So they also have the spirit jersey. So this one has.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
And that's
has the Boysenberries, and then they have the pies and Boysenberries on the sleeve.
Oh What's on the back?
And then on the back, we have Knott's.
Oh, that's
Boysenberry
cool.
Festival. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's pretty neat. And it goes for $70, $69.99.
Not bad.
Not bad.
I like it. I like the, it's embroidered too.
Yeah.
So that's really nice.
It's pretty cool. I like that. It's pretty neat.
Awesome. Oh, farm fresh boysenberry. That's good. It's a light. Looks like it's a light material too.
Light
right?
material.
Or lightweight.
Which one do you think between this one and that purple one?
The purple one's a little more subtle. This is a little more.
Yeah.
You know, it's out there kind of thing.
Yeah, it has a lot. Huh?
But it also has the sparkle in the logo too that you see there.
Yeah.
It's very sparkly.
Very sparkly.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I don't know. They have like a, it's like a crop top sweater type.
Oh
shirt
yeah, like a thing. Crop top. Oh no, yeah.
Five minutes till, and the line for Ghost Rider is pretty crazy already. But it's really neat. They have a lot of the decor set up for Boysenberry Festival. A lot of people here today for to try all the treats out that we're gonna be trying out as well. So can't wait to try all that stuff. So over here at Ghost Town Bakery, which is over here right across from Ghost Rider, looks like they're gonna have some options here. So it looks like here you're gonna find the cucumber and boysenberry lemonade, the lemon bar with the boysenberry compote. Some lemon and boysenberry gourmet cookie, boysenberry and chocolate stuffed cookie, and the boysenberry bundt cake will be found here, as well as the warm Spam Musubi. Oh, I gotta try that one. That one I can't wait. And then the vegan boysenberry chia parfait also is here at the Ghost Town Bakery. Right back. So here at Calico Tater Bites, you're gonna get the deep fried shrimp, which is over tots, with the boysenberry coleslaw and cilantro crema. Looks pretty good. And you can find the Calico Tater Bites right here, right at the beginning of the right here at the beginning of the park. It looks like over here at Sutter's Pizza, which is right next to the Calico Tater Bites, you have the pickle and potato pizza with boysenberry garlic Alfredo.
Thank you. Bye.
So over here at Settle's Funnel Cakes, they have the Fun Bun, which is a deep fried cinnamon bun with boysenberry glaze and a double stack. Wow, what's that about? Oh man, it's a double stack. It's like a double-double. Double stack boysenberry. Icing and birthday funnel cake. Wow, that's a lot. Plenty of seating area here over at Knott's for the Boysenberry Festival. We have all the seating that you can see right behind me here. So, you always find a spot to sit. One of the things I like about Knott's too is that they offer opportunity for a lot of local vendors to come in and sell their products here, and which is all these booths here. They have a lot of specialty booths that are just here to sell their products. It's pretty cool.
Boysenberry soda, some dark chocolate malted. What?
We gotta do a slight mic change in it. ended up being a little weird. Hey, you think Sad Eye Joe's awake?
I don't know. Let's go wake
him up. Let's go see. It's a Boysenberry Festival. Sorry. He better be awake.
Let's go see.
Snoring?
Hi, happy Boysenberry Day.
He's still asleep.
He's still asleep. Come on, it's Boysenberry Day.
You know, I don't know that many people that sleep that much for that long.
Man, he sleeps deeply. I wish I could sleep like that.
I know.
Not wake up.
Maybe they give him like some like super sleepy pills for the Boysenberry Festival so he doesn't run amok.
Yeah.
I don't have to worry about him when all the people are here.
I know.
That's probably what it is.
Sad-Eye Joe. Do we need to bring you like a pie or some chocolates or...
You know what? Yeah, we need to bring him one of those Boysenberry lattes.
Oh, Boysenberry lattes.
That'll wake him up.
Yeah.
All
right. I don't know if it'll fit through here, but we'll try.
Yeah. We can. I think we could squeeze it in there, right there.
Yeah. We'll try and... Oh, look, her foot's out. So those lights probably light up, making it all nice and purpley and everything.
Yeah, probably really,
really
gets that, really get, grabs that, that decor,
the purpley decor. Yeah, that's cool.
I never heard the catawampus do that. He went, rawr. You guys ever heard that before? I've never heard him do that before. I think he's excited from all the boysenberries going around. I'm super excited.
Aww, these little catawampus juniors.
That's cool.
That's cool.
At first, when I heard it, I thought it was animals in the
That's
barn.
That's what I thought too.
But that was coming from the catawampus.
It was a catawampus. Well, at least I think.
Some more vendors merch. Oh, this one's pretty neat. All your bracelets and stuff. All the tutus. Huh? Oh, wow. Made right here. They have the tool right there to make it with. Really neat. Merch.
Oh, and then the boysenberry. So the price is 1 for $15 or 2 for $25. I think that's a great idea. That's a great deal.
And they have the honey over here, it looks like. Where's the honey? They have merch, more merch over here. Boot Hill Diggins. Oh, not a whole lot going on here. Just waiting for Scary Farm. That's about it.
That's it.
So this is the line for the Wilderness Patio Bar. And over here, it looks like they're gonna have some boysenberry beef barbacoa with mac and cheese and green onions. Ooh, that would be good to try. But it's mac and cheese.
Oh, yeah, we have this one, right?
Yeah. The boysenberry sangria. Oh, with that one right there. That's the boysenberry beef barbacoa. Right there. And that one right there, I think, is the pork loin slices over mashed potatoes with a creamy boysenberry mustard sauce. And of course, you get all the, you get all your wines and your IPAs right here as well. Yeah. Okay, so we just confirmed, but all the tasting booths for the Boysenberry Festival should be open by 11. So if you're early birds like us, you want to get here, if you get here a little earlier, there's some things open, but majority of the booths are at 11.
But you can take a look at all the decor and all the shops, because the shops are open and the booths, some of the crafts, like the vendors, craft vendors and just vendors here special for the Boysenberry Festival, they're open already. So you can go ahead and shop around, look around, and then, you know, then come get yourself your tasting treats.
So over here at the Wilderness Dance Hall, they have your charcuterie board, boysenberry and parmesan, boysenberry juice, mint and cucumber gin spritzers, and cucumber and boysenberry lemonade, which sounds really good. They also have the boysenberry cobbler here, the boysenberry West Coast IPA, and the blackened shrimp stir fry with lemon rice and boysenberry teriyaki sauce. That one sounded good. That one sounded really good. And then the boysenberry rimmed espresso martini with lavender sprinkles is here. And then the boysenberry punch and pineapple juice rum runner also. You can get that here with the boysenberry barbecue chicken wings are here as well. And again, I believe they said at 11 o'clock is when they open up. So definitely want to hit up the Wilderness Dance Hall, right? That had a lot of good...
A lot of good items and stuff.
A lot of good yummy treats that we just saw. The shrimp and rice, I believe.
The shrimp and lemon rice. And then they had the barbecue, the boysenberry barbecue chicken wings.
That was good too. And then they also had the boysenberry espresso martini.
I'm excited to try that.
So that one's going to be good too. We'll definitely have to visit this one.
Definitely.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
Well, it looks like Calico River Rapids is closed right now. I'm not sure if that's still in refurbishment, but as of right now, it's closed. Maybe it'll open up later on the day. I'm not sure. We'll see. Oh, they even got the tiki gods out. Boysenberry tiki gods are out right there. So here at this cart, you're going to get the seasonal elote or esquite. And the boysenberry pulled pork is also available here. And again, this cart here is located right in this area, right next to Calico Saloon, right there.
Boysenberry pulled pork over pastel de elote.
Wow,
so
that sounds good.
I'm thinking it's like a corn mush type with the boysenberry pulled pork over it.
Oh, that could be good.
That could be really good.
Yeah, for sure. I want to try that. Definitely. Okay.
Yeah.
Another one on the list that we're going to come visit.
Or, you know, try to visit today.
Yeah, we'll try and get that one today.
But we're going to be back anyways.
Yeah. You know, I like that they have these little, like, placards. They kind of give you the history of the Boysenberry Festival and what it's about and stuff. It's not just, you know, boysenberries everywhere, food. It's actually kind of giving you a little bit of more of a background of what Boysenberry Festival is and stuff. So when you come check out the Boysenberry Festival, make sure you catch these. These are located at all these little display areas.
Different areas throughout the park, I'm noticing.
There you go.
Learn some history.
All right, let's go.
Let's keep moving.
So over here at the Calico Saloon, it looks like they have the boysenberry mojito, boysenberry hurricane, boysenberry lemon drop martini, and the boysenberry margarita. Ooh, it all sounds yummy.
I think the mojito sounds good.
for the lemon drop, Boysenberry lemon drop martini.
That sounds good too.
I want that espresso tea.
That hurricane sounds pretty good too. It sounds like it might be a little tropical kind of drink there and stuff. So
yeah, maybe like a Mai Tai.
Should we go get one?
Let's go get one.
Are they open? Oh, let's ask. Let me get some footage. Nice.
Are you open yet? Oh, okay.
Mojito. Let's go up. You want to go up top and have it? You want to go up top or walk? Let's walk around, huh?
Let's walk. Yeah, let's walk around.
Okay. Okay. So we got the Boysenberry Mojito. Looks pretty good. What do you think about it?
Mm-hmm. It's pretty good. I could really taste that boysenberry in there.
Yeah?
And the mint.
Is it mint? Yeah, mojito should be real minty and stuff, right? So should have
a... Let's see. I get a lot of boysenberry.
Okay. Oh, a lot of boysenberry?
The mint. But it's really refreshing.
So they must pump like a lot of boysenberry syrup or some sort of liqueur into it and
into
stuff.
The
so
drink, yeah.
Let me give it a try. I'll try it. Yeah. Let's see. All right, here
it's
we go.
It's refreshing though. It's very like.
Wow.
It's good.
Yeah, so it's very, I get like a lemon. Very
lemony,
with some mint flavor in there, and then the boysenberry kind of comes in after.
Yeah, it's really good.
I don't taste any of the alcohol though.
You know what? Honestly, don't taste too much alcohol.
Yeah, I taste. It's real syrupy, so it's really tastes
real
like a
sweet.
Juice.
It's sweet.
Yeah.
But it's tasty. It's really good.
Yeah.
But
it tastes.
I don't taste alcohol.
You know what it tastes like to me is like a boysenberry lemonade.
Yes.
That's what it tastes like. Boysenberry lemonade.
I get that hint of mint, a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. There's a mint, like a boysenberry. I think they sell it. I think they have it here over at the Wilderness Dance Hall.
Yeah.
The boysenberry lemonade, mint lemonade.
Oh,
I think
mint
they have
lemonade.
That.
Yes.
I wonder if it's gonna taste the same like that. So.
I know.
We'll see. No, they didn't. So this year they didn't really do a, usually they do this fountain all up, but instead they just decided to run it.
And yeah.
I kind of like it.
I like it.
It's very
like
soothing.
It. Yeah.
You know?
Plenty of places to sit down and relax and eat your tastings. You could just sit around. I think maybe that's why they, you know, they don't do it all up then. Can't really run the fountain with all the decor and stuff.
Yeah, and it gives off a pretty good ambiance too, because it's starting to get a little warm now. It's supposed to be like 70-ish today.
Yeah.
And there's a nice cool breeze, and I think it could be coming from that fountain right there.
Yep.
So
yeah,
maybe that was the intent with not decorating it this year, which I think they did a good job with.
Yeah, it looks really cool.
Yeah.
Very relaxing.
You know, not too much decor here in the Goring 20s area. I call it Goring 20s because that's the only way I know of it. But usually they would have this all decked out back there, right? Like with like boysenberry stuff and all that up here and all that. Maybe some bunting, but...
I don't see much. No, it's
I'm not seeing it.
Yeah, maybe more just where the festival activities are at. Maybe that's where they...
Yeah, I think last year though, they had like bunting, like all up in this area here. There was bunting up there and all that. There's a little more purple. Today is the first day, so I give them that. So maybe as the festival progresses, we'll start seeing a little more decor here and stuff.
Yeah.
So, all right. Just wanted to point that out.
Yeah.
Sipping on this drink is good, but it's real sugary and it kind of leaves like that that mucky feeling in your mouth from all the sugar?
Yeah.
It's good. If you like a lot of sugar, it's really good. Yeah, that major sweet tooth.
It's sweet.
It's good. But I wish there was a little bit more alcohol in it, though.
I know.
You know, for $19, could have put that extra shot in there. Let's see what they have here. So here at Prop Shop Pizza, you have the Boysenberry Sausage and Honey Pizza, the Caprese Stuffed Portobello, ooh, that sounds good, with a Boysenberry Balsamic Drizzle, and the Boysenberry Layered No-Bake Cheesecake Cup. Ooh, what's that about? Ooh. And then you get the Boysenberry Rimmed Espresso Martini with lavender spice sprinkles.
That sounds good.
There's another spot right here.
Another spot.
So excited.
I'm so excited. I want to try that.
So now we're headed into coasters. So now we're headed into the boardwalk area to see what kind of decor we see here for the Boysenberry Festival and stuff. So
yeah,
let's see
what decor. I don't see any.
Nothing yet.
Maybe they're still working on it. It's a work in progress, which is fine. You know, because it does run, I think, till the end of April. Right?
Yeah.
So there's time still.
Yeah, for sure.
The flowers haven't bloomed yet, you know?
I like that. The Boysenberry flowers have not bloomed yet.
Yes, you can't rush those. You can't say. You know.
Yeah. All right.
All in good time.
All in good time. So over here at Coaster's Diner, which still looks like it's closed, but they're going to be opening it up pretty soon. They're going to have the Boysenberry Shake with the Oreo Churro, the French Toast Burger with the Boysenberry Syrup, and the Blackened Salmon Bowl with Boysenberry Sour Cream.
That
one sounds good.
Sounds good.
Yeah, I want to try that one when it opens up. Hopefully,
that sounds good.
I'm hoping it opens up soon, though.
That's kind of different. I think that's, I don't know about French Toast and Cheeseburger, but...
I'll try it.
I wouldn't knock it until you try it, right?
Yeah. So you gotta try that for sure.
I wonder if it comes with like boysenberry butter.
Hey, that could be good.
It comes with boysenberry syrup.
Yeah.
Sweet, savory, you know? Hey.
We'll try it.
Yeah.
We'll have to try it.
Try it.
You know what? It doesn't open till 11, like all the, and we're here 5 minutes till, so it's possible that it's gonna open today. We'll report back and let you guys know.
We'll
see.
Open.
Hopefully it is.
Yeah.
Excited to see all the renovations they've done.
Yes.
In there.
Yes.
So over here at Casa California Restaurant, they have the Boysenberry Chicken Tinga Nachos, the Boysenberry Salsa and Sour Cream, and the Boysenberry Concha. Oh, that looks pretty good.
That looks pretty good.
Yeah. All right.
Nice.
Now we're headed through Forsaken Lake.
Forsaken Lake?
No, just kidding. Not yet. We're a little early on that one.
I can't wait.
I know. Can't wait.
That's going to be fun.
Well, guys, that was it for today. Just kidding, actually. We left because we're going to go over to the 30 Acres Restaurant and give that a try. And,
yes. And then come back and have some tastings.
Oh, yeah. We had one tasting, which was the Boysenberry Mojito.
Oh.
But that just starts us off right.
Yes. It was delicious.
Yeah.
Refreshing, delicious.
It was good.
It's a little on the sweet side, but that's okay.
Yeah.
But it was good.
All right. So follow us over to Knott's Hotel to check out the 30 Acres Restaurant.
Yeah. Let's go. Getting ready to have some lunch. First time here, so let's see what we get, what we try.
So we ordered the Southwest egg rolls and the a personal size boysenberry chipotle barbecue chicken pizza, personal pizza, for us to share. And also, we also ordered the, also to share, boysenberry barbecue chicken salad. So we're excited to try those three items. And he did say the personal pizza is a little big, so hopefully not too big. But
yeah, hopefully it's not too big, because we still have to go get some Boysenberry Festival goodies after this, so we'll see.
But we can always take it to go?
Yeah. Alright.
So let's see what it's all about. All right. Hungry. I think we were hungry when we were ordering.
So, getting ready. That fireplace is going to be here soon enough for the summer, hopefully.
It's going to be neat to eat.
Awesome. Go out there and eat, have a drink, by the fire.
Yeah.
That's going to be so cool.
Hopefully they put heating lamps like on the rest of the patio area.
Yeah, I think they will.
Yeah.
Wow, look at those things.
Oh my god.
They're huge. We still have to eat at the Boysenberry Festival after this, you know that, right?
Wow. Looks like we're going to be taking some home.
I think so. Wow.
Yikes.
Right, let's give them a whirl.
Let's give them a try.
Ouch. This is huge.
Very right. Big.
So I'm going to try this Southwest, I'm going to call it spicy. Egg roll. And it's got a whole bunch of goodness inside of there. Like it's got chicken and corn and some kind of, maybe like a pinto bean or something? I don't know. Let's try it. It's falling apart, so I gotta eat it.
How's that salsa?
Mmm. Spicy.
Spicy?
Oh, very spicy, but good.
Oh no.
Mm-hmm. It's delicious.
Delicious. Oh my gosh.
Definitely, if you're hungry, these are really good.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Okay, I don't know about that spicy salsa. I'm gonna taste it a little on my own.
It's pica.
It is pica. Okay, let's give it a try. Hopefully I don't drop all this stuff here. Okay, here we go. Delicious. Let's try it with
now.
The salsa now.
Try with the salsa. Gives it a little bit of a kick.
Okay, I'll try it with the salsa.
Go to town.
I won't go chicken.
Get more.
Alright.
We got water.
Okay, got water. Here we go. That's delicious.
Yeah.
Almost it does give it a kick.
But it's almost like it's big enough that the salsa is spicy to compensate for the large amount of food that you're gonna eat right now.
Yeah. That's very good. Very delicious. Very tasty. And these, by all means, are not little egg rolls. They're big egg rolls.
This is my AirPod case. This is the egg roll.
But they're delicious. This is a, I want to say this is a can't miss item.
Yeah, it's really good.
It's really good. Definitely really good.
So what you got there?
So we got the barbecue, boysenberry barbecue chicken salad. And then we also have the barbecue chipotle chicken pizza. It's a personal pizza, so as you can see, the personal size, the size of it, kind of big.
It's a good size. Yeah.
It's a good size.
Definitely shareable. The definitely. Two of them are definitely shareable.
Yeah, definitely.
I think you add the egg rolls and you're just asking for too much. I don't know.
They're big, but they're so delicious.
They are good.
I don't know. I may have to eat it.
I know, me too. All right, let's dig in.
All right.
right, let's dig in.
Okay.
So it looks like this has some beans, some corn, cheese. It looks like romaine lettuce. You have the tomatoes and some chicken. And it looks like what Nat's pouring over right now is that like a...
Tortilla chips.
The tortilla chips, but is the salsa, the sauce, is that like a...
Oh, it's like a...
Boysenberry sauce?
Let me taste
that sauce.
Kind of like a chipotle ranch.
Is it really? Like a chipotle?
Or a boysenberry ranch.
Oh, it's definitely a ranch sauce.
A ranch.
Maybe it's a boysenberry ranch. I think so.
Yeah.
And then the chicken looks like it has like some boysenberry sauce kind of on it, like a barbecue.
Boysenberry barbecue, I think.
So maybe that's just like a ranch. I don't know. We'll show you the description.
Yeah.
And then our pizza has some barbecue chicken, some onion straws on top, and it looks like it's in a barbecued boysenberry sauce.
Yeah,
looks good.
Let's dig in. All of it looks good. All right, so we got the barbecue chicken salad, boysenberry barbecue chicken salad. We're gonna go ahead and give it a try. Let's see, I gave it a mix. Hopefully it's a good mix. So I'm just gonna make sure I got some of the goodness here. Ooh, there's a lot of goodness.
Yeah,
a lot of good stuff here. So,
That's delicious.
Definitely good. John's gonna go ahead and give it a try.
Let's see what this is all about.
Yeah.
Give it a little twisty. Let's see here. Oh, I'm gonna dig in here and try and get as much. Can't get anything on my fork.
I was having trouble too.
Okay, that's as good as a bite as I'm gonna get right now. There's a sweet taste to it somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Maybe boysenberry.
You get the sweetness, the boysenberry sauce, and then you can taste the spice of the chipotle ranch that's over all that stuff. Very good. The lettuce is very crisp, not soggy at all. You can have that crisp in every bite.
Mm-hmm.
And the tomatoes, which I didn't get much of. Let me try it again. Everything has that good crisp. You can tell it's a good fresh salad.
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
Oh, it's so good.
I would definitely recommend you guys trying this. But make sure you share it.
Yeah.
It's a big salad.
It's a huge salad. And the Maygrills.
Yeah. All right. I'm gonna try the Chipotle Boysenberry Barbecue Cheese Pizza. Say that 10 times fast. So I opted to take off. It comes with onion straws, but I don't like onions, so I took mine off. But let's give it a try. Let's see what it's all about. Initial bite, I can taste the boysenberry flavor coming right out at barbecue. Not too cheesy, which I like. I don't really like a super cheesy pizza. And there's a good crisp to the bread. Bread's really good, not soggy, more of a flatbread style bread. And it is oven baked, so really good. Different try.
Ooh. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and give it a try. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna try it with the onion straws. Let's see how that is all together. That's really good.
Really good. Got like a sweetness to it. Maybe that's the boysenberry.
I think it's a boysenberry. Definitely a recommend.
Yeah.
So I am gonna try a little hack. I have a little bit of that chipotle ranch dressing that I got from that we got from the with the salad. So I'm gonna try it on the egg roll.
Oh,
and
hey.
See what that's what that is like. And maybe next time we can ask that ask for it on the side. Let me see if I can.
Just in case you're not into that super spice of the salsa.
Let me give it a little whirl. Ask for some chipotle ranch on the side. Maybe they'll give you some on the side, so you could try it with the egg rolls if you come to 30 Acres and you order this as an appetizer. Try it with the ranch, or even just ranch.
Yeah, that would be good.
But the chipotle ranch, give it a good, good flavor. I mean, it has flavor, enough flavor by itself, but,
yeah.
You know.
All right. So, as we're continuing eating this salad, man, there's a spice that keeps building up. It's like one of those spices that the more and more you eat, the more and more it builds up. So, if you're into spice, you're going to like it. You can always order the salad without the sauce, the chipotle ranch sauce that we put on it, and maybe just a regular ranch if you're not into spice. But so far, all the ingredients mixing together is really good.
Yeah.
Definitely delicious. So guys, we just had some lunch over at the 30 Acres restaurant, and it was really good. I had a everything we had was really good.
Mm-hmm. Yes, everything was good. We had the Southwest egg rolls.
Yeah.
Which were delicious.
Mm-hmm. Those are good. They're really big.
Yeah, really big, big egg portions. Rolls. So.
Yeah. And then we had the Chipotle barbecue.
Personal pizza.
It's the Chipotle Boysenberry Barbecue Chicken Personal Pizza.
Yes, it's a mouthful.
But that was really good. That was really good. And the personal size was about the right size for sharing and stuff with the salad. Yeah. And then we also had those...
Boysenberry Barbecue Chicken Salad.
Which
was also delicious. Yeah, enough for both of us as well. It's a big salad.
Yeah.
So just know when ordering the salad, but it's delicious.
Yeah.
Very delicious.
Overall, I think the food was really good. The ambiance is really nice and relaxing. Good place to kind of go, get away from the park for a bit, and just eat and rest your feet for a little bit. So.
Yeah, definitely. They also have a full service bar too. We didn't order any drinks. They weren't serving the drinks.
Yeah,
yet.
The bartender had. Comes at a certain time, so they can do like just real simple things like beers and things like that. But as far as like
margaritas
and stuff,
or special drinks, no.
They don't do that. So, but we're gonna head into the back into the Knots for the Boysenberry Festival.
Yeah.
So why don't you guys come along with us?
Get some dessert.
Yeah.
We'll see what we can get.
All right, guys, come on with us.
Come join us.
So guys, it looks like the Timber Mountain log ride is still closed. I think they're just down for renovations right now, some refurbishments. So hopefully, as the warm months approach, this will be back up and running to help cool us off. So over here on Strictly on a Stick, that's where you're going to find the Boysenberry Corn Dog. Looks like it's a pretty good one, and it's a really good size from what I've seen from what people are carrying away from the booth there. You know, even though it's Boysenberry Festival, that panda is always super popular. There's always a big line coming out the door for Panda Express. Good stuff. Who can blame them? So the Boysenberry Festival is in full swing now. We got a whole bunch of people arriving for some good boysenberry treats and fun.
It's Whittles. He's so Whittle.
Okay. Hopefully you guys can hear us okay.
Yeah.
I'm sure you can. I trust that mic.
You know.
Okay, so what do we get? You want to introduce yourself?
So we got the boysenberry on cobbler. So let me just give you a little view of what it looks like. And we got the boysenberry espresso martini. Not big. It looks good.
That's all like espresso martini, like mixed.
Yeah.
Wow, that's gonna be a big drink.
Yeah, so I'm gonna give it a little stir because I know that the ice has been melting in here. So give it a little stir. And then I'm excited to try this. So I'm gonna go ahead and give it a try.
Looks good.
It has sprinkles, so it sticks all to your lip. It's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
It's refreshing. I feel like it needs some cold foam on top.
Yeah, it looks like it's just like a dark coffee with some vodka. I mean, that's what makes a martini, right?
Yeah.
Vodka.
But it's good. It's sweet. It has like a sweetness to it.
It looks like it's got, oh, you can see it dripping. Right here.
Oh, yes.
You can see all
boysenberry.
The...
Maybe that's the boysenberry.
It's melting.
Let me taste it. I'm just going to do this real quick. Yep, boysenberry syrup.
I'm not going to taste. Try it.
Is that good?
It's good. I mean, it's very... get that coffee flavor. Very
yeah.
Coffee.
It's like got a strong...
It's like an espresso, so mm-hmm. Got a lot of coffee flavor. There's sweetness to it. You get a sweetness. I think it's from the boysenberry around the rim. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I like it.
No.
It's no carajillo.
No. I know, I mentioned that.
Yeah.
Yeah, the carajillo at Corte. Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
That was...
But here. As far as this one, I think it's good. We'll probably drink some of it. I mean, I'll probably drink some of it. I don't know if I like it, though, to drink all of it.
It's, I think it's missing the cream, the cold foam on top.
I think, yeah. Yeah, that's a good layer.
I think if it had that, I think it would really make it more,
yeah,
like, smooth, creamy. But I guess,
yeah,
an espresso tea.
It's supposed to be espresso.
Espresso.
That's even worse.
It is coffee, and you can taste the alcohol in it too. I do taste some alcohol in it.
Yeah.
So
there is. It is. Yeah. I can definitely. The alcohol does come through. It's a strong coffee though. So if you're not into strong coffee, it's not a cream. It's more of a bitter coffee, like a Starbucks type bitter coffee. Not saying that all Starbucks coffees are bitter. I'm just saying bitter.
Yeah. It's strong.
Yeah.
It's like espresso. That's what it is, espresso, the burnt, like,
yeah,
you know.
Would I get it again? I probably wouldn't. Would you get it again?
I don't think I would. But it's still good. I mean.
Yeah, it's good.
I mean, it's good.
I'll drink it. Somewhat.
I wouldn't. Like, it's good, but it's not one of those that drinks, like, usually if I have something really, really good. I'll have it again and again and again. It's hard to break that habit to stop ordering it.
Yeah.
But it's good. Overall, it is good. I just want some, you know, some cold foam on top or
something.
Something
to break it up
that.
A little bit.
Something to smooth it.
Yeah. Were you able to get this on the pass? Or?
Yes.
Oh.
So I was able to get it with the tasting card. So I was able to get this. It looks pretty big to me.
Yeah, it's so, a good size.
It's a good size.
Probably the same one that if you were to buy. And this is probably like, what, like that $18, $20 drink?
Yeah.
Right here. So.
Yeah. So it looks about the same size as the other one, right?
Yeah.
Or was the other one a little bigger?
You know what? The other one, we had the mojito earlier, yeah, and it was actually, it was bigger.
It was a little bigger. It was a bigger cup. So, I mean, they don't skimp on the drinks here.
No, not
so
at all.
So you're going to get, you know, if you pay $19, you're going to get $19 worth.
Yeah.
If it has the option.
It has the, yeah.
Yeah, because the other one.
Three shots, maybe $19.
But this one, I mean, that sounds pretty good. I recommend to try it. But like I said, it needs some cold foam. Maybe if you go to a coffee place and I don't know how that would be.
Yeah.
Some creamer in it, but.
Well, we're going to try this next one here.
Oh, yeah. Okay. On to the next one.
Is the Boysenberry Cobbler. So you got like your, what do you really call that?
It's a, that's like the cobbler. The,
like the crumb pie crust or
like
something?
A crumb.
Yeah.
Like a pastry crumb.
Yeah. You can try it. Let's see. Looks good.
I've been curious about buying the cobbler mix that they sell here at Knott's.
Oh, you think this might be the same thing?
It might be.
Mmm. Oh. Mmm. Good.
I'm gonna have to try it.
It's got that pie crust taste, but it's a sweet, like a sugary, crusty taste. And the boysenberries.
You get a good.
They're not too, they're not bitter at all. They're actually kind of nice and sweet. So it's not a real bitter food. It's really good. Is it cold?
It was warm.
It was warm when you got it, so it's
warm.
It
wasn't hot, but it was warm.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's cool. So
oh,
it's not
with
cold.
A scoop of ice cream on top.
We should have went over and got a scoop of ice cream put on top. You know,
would have been a good idea.
I forgot the name of the place. Over both
there
by no, there's that. Isn't there that one over by Calico Saloon?
Yes, the by the churro.
Yeah, right there where they have like the ice cream and all the beignets. The beignets are right there.
Okay.
Boom.
That's a hat. Get yourself this. Get yourself a scoop of ice cream.
Something with ice cream.
The soft serve ice cream. I'm sure they probably have the boysenberry ice cream.
Probably do. Yeah.
And pour it on top of that. I'm curious. That would probably be good.
Good. Really good. I like it.
Yeah, this is really good.
Looks like they're getting ready for the pie eating contest right over there. So everybody's in their purples.
It's,
and I'm getting
pinched.
You
don't wear purple, you get pinched. Those are the rules.
I'm stuck in peanut celebration mode. That's why.
It's no purple.
I'm still stuck in
there's
peanut
no
celebration. That's why. I'm not ready for the boysenberry yet. This year's going by way too fast.
That's true.
All right, guys. So that was our visit today for the first day of the Knott's Berry Farm Boysenberry Festival.
Yes.
2004.
Yes. We ate at 30 acres and
That's
had some
good.
Yummy food and had some dessert with our tasting cards.
Yeah.
We will be back to have more tasty treats.
Yeah,
know?
For sure.
Yeah.
We still had, we kind of used two, we used about four of them, but really two of them were to
That's
take something back to the kids.
Yeah.
So.
That's
wasn't really
okay.
here. But we're definitely going to be back for some more of the food because there's over 90 items, I think is what they said,
yeah.
that's available.
Yeah.
So it's crazy. There's a lot of food here to be had. So. We'll definitely be back to get some more and dive into that stuff.
Yeah, and with the tasting card, you get six tastings.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. So, and that includes alcohol, which
yeah.
I found out.
Alcohol is included too.
Yeah.
So, who knew?
I know.
But yeah, so make sure you guys like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so that when you see our new videos pop up, you get notified. Because we'll be back. We'll have some more of the boysenberry coverage coming your way. So
yes, so stay tuned.
All right, talk to you later. See you guys later.
Bye.
I know these guys. I see them on TV all the time.
Hey, how you doing? Crash Zero, and Wicked Journeys.
On the road again.
On the road again.
Gotta pick up the kids on the road again.
Are you ready?
Oh, wait, let me take off my...
Oh, good point. You see me.
Yeah, there we go.
All right.
Hey guys, we're here again today over here.
Let's do that over again. What do you think, guys? I can show my belly, right? You don't want to see that either. This is just a test. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Can you hear me? I can hear you.
So if you're early birds like us. Actually, it had a lot of good things. It had the shrimp with the rice, right? Oh, we wanted to try that. It had the Boysenberry Martini Espresso.
That's exactly
that was there. Also had the, I'm trying to get a different backdrop.
Oh.
Sorry. Okay, so, but yeah, over here at the wilderness, that's okay.
Poison.
How's it going?
Poison.
Who is that? Who sang that one?
Belle Biv DeVoe.
Now you know.
Poison.
No, but it's poison right now. Poison.
Poison. We just redid it to poison.
Yeah.